What's up, everyone? Welcome back. I'm Blake McLain, and I'm a music producer. So just full disclosure, I do this at the beginning of all my videos now. This is Motley. He's my kitten. He's only about 8 weeks old. So he's really hyper, and he's probably going to be jumping around on stuff. And if he interrupts anything, just ignore it. But yeah, I figured if any fandom was okay with that, it'd be Swifties. So that being said, today we are doing All Too Well, Taylor's version. It's a 10-minute version. And I do just want to say, I have not listened to Red in a very, very, very long time. So I vaguely remember this. And I don't remember the lyrics necessarily or anything like that. So I'm going to have a hard time kind of comparing the two. But I'm still going to pick out a bunch of cool stuff in this, hopefully, and, you know, talk about it and really talk about the production and everything. And maybe in another video, I'll go and I'll actually listen to the other one and then compare the two. But since this is a reaction, I'm just going to jump right into it. Before we get started, though, as always, please give me a like, give me a subscribe if you enjoy the content and the channel. And if you want exclusive content or just to support the channel, please go check out the Patreon. You guys know that I like to do a lot of stuff in the music industry, working with artists and, you know, just really like looking for a good place in the industry. And I really want to make a good difference. So being on the Patreon helps support all that, and anything you guys give me on there is going towards a really good cause and good positive things. So again, please go check it out. The link is in the description. And you can follow me on Twitch too. I do custom requests on Twitch a couple times a week, and that's down in the description too. And like, subscribe, all that stuff, if I didn't already say that. And Twitter, Instagram, you know the whole drill. So let's jump in. That was weird. I just like lost my breath for a second. It's All Too Well.
I walked to the door with you. The air was cold, but something about it felt like home somehow. And I left my scarf there at your sister's house, and you still got it.
First off, I just love how descriptive she is with all of her lyrics. She's one of the few artists that can do that that isn't necessarily in country music. Even though I know this record was a little more geared towards country, it still, especially this, feels more pop. You have that bass line under that's going, gung, 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 you know, those eighth notes. And it just kind of, it does, it gives it a modern flair.
In your drawer, even
and the pad and everything. Something else that's actually really kind of cool just to note from a production standpoint, the beginning, everything, you had this like the slide guitar that had a bunch of verb on it and all those things. It kind of, it was her reflecting. So it's the music feels like it's her reflecting. You know what I mean? It feels like you're looking back. That's why everything was so distant. And now that she's talking a little bit more in the present tense, everything is way more forward. The drums are forward, like her vocal is forward, all of that.
Okay, but I'm not fine.
I remember this song.
Photo album on the counter. Your cheeks were turning red. You used to be a little kid with glasses in a twin-sized bed. And your mother's telling stories about you on the T-ball team. You told me about your
Jack Antonoff, do this one with her. Because it almost feels like it. Buddy, really, you had to do that? There we go. I gotta check really fast because it almost feels like he did. Hold on. Where's the credits? Jack Antonoff. I was gonna say you have those like 16th notes underneath, you know, with the like the hats and stuff like that. And he always does that with his music. That and it just kind of helps move things forward. But back to it.
Can you, if you choose me and you were tossing me the car keys, but the patriarchy,
nice.
Keychain on the ground. We were always skipping town. And I was thinking on the drive down.
Notice too how her vocal, she's getting more intense with this. Like, she's staying in the same place and not necessarily using like jumping up the octave or anything like that to really make it hit home. It's just the actual vocal itself is getting more intense, which is one of my favorite techniques ever. You know, it's all about the delivery. How this song is still building, and I'm sure it's going to continue to grow. I mean, and it's already hitting me like right here, just lyrically and everything. And like I said, the delivery, this takes you on a journey. Shit. I gotta take a second. This one hits me. This one definitely hits me. Like right home. You know, I also want to say that this song, it really doesn't, like vocally, it doesn't move that much, you know, it's really staying in the same spots, and it really is accentuated by the music. The music is probably one of the most important elements in this song because of how much it builds that vocal when it's staying right where it is, you know, like that is the absolute key to really making this feel like it is. And obviously, again, the delivery of it.
Shine a flex on you. Not weeping in a party bathroom. Some actress asking me what happened. You, that's what happened. You, you who charmed my dad with self-effacing jokes. Sipping coffee like you're on a late night show. But then he watched me watch the front door all night, willing you to come. And he
you guys know, if you watch the channel, I'm having a hard time. I'm having a hard time talking about this one. And I don't normally get very emotional with songs, you know, aside from, you know, some of the ones that I've written. So, sorry, I'm not talking like as much as I kind of normally do. This one just, like I said, it hits.
Time won't fly, it's like I'm paralyzed by it. I'd like to be my old self again, but I'm still trying to find it. After plaid shirt days and nights when you made me your own, now you mail back my things and I walk home alone. But you keep my old scarf from that very first week, 'cause it reminds you of innocence and it smells like me. You can't get rid of it,
thing about the lyrics. I think one of the reasons that this does so well and that this song really does hit nicely, you know, for a lot of people, I mean, there's some very like specific pieces of it, you know, that are a little bit more general, and like the idea is kind of, you know, there. It, hey buddy, I know, come here. Yeah, sorry about that. The idea can appeal to a lot of people, like those general ones. And then it's the specificity of the things that she goes into that makes it even more relatable. You know, it builds it up even more, because what it does is it shows you that other people go through the exact same thing. And so hearing someone else's specific story that's somehow relevant to something that you've gone to or gone through is like one of the most comforting things, you know, on the planet. It just makes you feel like you're not necessarily alone in the things that you go through, and that, you know, I mean, humans are all about communication and contact, and that's the whole point of music, is to communicate, which is why she's a master at what she does, an absolute master at what she does. So.
It was rare, I was there, I remember it all too. Who's returning half her weight, and did the twin flame bruise paint you blue?
Yeah, you know, that's the other thing too, like even if your situation isn't as specific as, you know, that, I mean, she was obviously like dating somebody that was older than her and stuff, but like if yours is different than that, it's still it, which is why, I mean, you know, I even feel it for me, like it's still in the same realm, you know? It's, I'm sorry, I know I keep like talking about it. I'm just kind of really thinking in depth about these.
Just between us, did the love affair maim you too? 'Cause in this city's barren cold, I still remember the first fall of snow and how it glistened as it fell. Between us, did the love affair maim you all too well? Just between us, do you remember it all too well? Just between us, I remember it all.
I love those harmonies too. Her little call and response harmonies are some of my favorites, because she always gets up in that little almost like mixed falsetto voice, and then they just layer a bunch of them on top of each other, and they have this like ethereal feel to them. horns in the back too. You know, the fade out on this one, I normally don't like fade outs. You guys know that, but the fade out on this one's appropriate because it's almost like it's literally something that you're sort of letting go of that is fading out. And this is, you know, writing a song like that helps somebody, I know for me, like it helps you come to terms with things, you know, and so it's almost like you're putting it out into the world and you're letting it go. And something like this specifically, it is, it's fading away. It's letting it go and facing it. That was incredible. I was very skeptical of a 10-minute song. I'm not going to lie. I was very skeptical, but it needs to be 10 minutes. It absolutely needs to be 10 minutes. Like, you have to get all that out in it. It's perfect. It's absolutely perfect. Anyways, thank you all so much for hanging around. Like I said, I know I didn't talk as much in this one as I normally do. This song was just a kind of a different experience for me. So thanks again for hanging around. I really hope you enjoyed it. And until next time, I will catch y'all later.